Happy birthday, Batch!
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday, Batch! 100 years old!
Woo!
Today we pulled everybody together to take just a few minutes to share some thoughts and appreciation of the impact that the school can have on a community and the community has had on the school. We are honored that so many people have made time to share with us this morning. For most people here, I imagine at some point, whether it be right now or 100 years ago, 50 years ago, this school has made an impact on your life. And since I've arrived at this school in 2001, we kind of set a simple bumper sticker vision for the school. And we always say our goals are as easy as ABC. And the A is for achievement. We always want our students and our staff and everybody involved with our community to do as well as they can. And we define achievement as being able to do something today that you weren't able to do yesterday. We talk about Bulldog Pride. It's the B. It's how we approach every task, everything we do with pride. And as you see here today, the students taking time out of their Saturday shows how much pride they have in their school that they want to be here and celebrate with us today. And the last one is community. The C is community. You know, we work hard to achieve and to be as successful as possible, but the pride we share, the work, it feeds the fire that we want our children to believe that they can do anything they want to and can make a difference if they're prepared to invest the time and the effort and work together. Within the community, I've been in North Reading for, it's my 22nd year. Believe it or not, I am older than 22. I get to look at what makes a bachelor's school such a special place. And it really, it's not as complex as some people might want to make it. It's the people. It's the people sitting up on the stage, the people in the seats, the people who couldn't make it here today. It's the people from 100 years ago, it's the people tomorrow. You talk to anybody when they're moving into town or ask a realtor, you know, they want to get into North Reading, they hear the schools are great, it's a special place to grow and learn, the community's fantastic, I'm going to raise my young family here. But it goes back to the people. And over 17 years as principal of Batchelder School, I've had the opportunity to work with so many talented people, the students, families, citizens, faculty, and staff. And it's these relationships that I've been able to share, observe, and enjoy that help take us to find out who we are and who we want to be as individuals and as a community. So as we move forward, we want to make the most of every opportunity and continue to challenge ourselves every day, every year, and every century to be the best that we can. For the school itself, the Pelley Bachelor School hasn't only survived for 100 years, it's flourished. From Leland Bachelor donating the land to create a school to replace two or three one-room schoolhouses, from the adaptations of wings being built on 5 years after completion of the original building, to the annex that was added in the 50s that came off the building and there's pictures outside, kind of get that. The 90s, they're adding the modular classrooms to meet the needs of the thriving community. You know, North Reading growing from that rural town to being so close to so many things, becoming more of a suburban area in demand with residences being built and schools being built. And the conflict of trying to build a new school, I did get to get into the tail end of that. And at the time, I didn't really have a strong inkling of whether I felt it needed to be in the center of town or if it needed to be at a different location. But it's our 13th year back, the LD Bachelor School. And I can't tell you how glad I am as a community that we decided to keep this school here. It is amazing when I drive up Haverhill Street and I get to see the building up under the hill. Whenever I drive by and come back from a meeting and the kids are outside playing at recess, they're all things that make me feel very special. And I'm warmed by the support of the community to do that. It was never about what the kids needed, it was just about where. And I'm glad that we stayed in the center of town, because now the LD Batchelder School gets to celebrate its 100th year. As we celebrate the building and its success it's had 100 years, on behalf of the school, let me thank all of you, from the past to the present and tomorrow, for keeping our eyes on the future, our students. Thank you very much. At this time, I'd like to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance, which will be led by Alex Gamer, fourth grade student. Thank you.
founder of the Batchelder School. Today we are here to celebrate the Batchelder School's 100th anniversary. The Batchelder School means a lot to me. Being a student here at the Batch has taught me to persevere, show respect, and to put effort into everything that I do. My favorite feature of the Batchelder School is the library. The library is where I can choose a great book. It's also where I get most of my ideas. I'm proud to be a Batchelder boy. Even though it's still school, the teachers here always make learning fun. I'd like to thank the NORCAM community for their 100 years of support. Because of all of the great citizens in this town, I get to be a part of this wonderful school.
And I'd like to introduce Andrew Massicott, who's going to share some thoughts.
Hello, my name is Andrew Massicott. I am a fifth grade student in Ms. Forrest's class. It is an honor to be speaking today representing my school, the LG Batchelder School, at the 100th anniversary celebration. The Batch holds a special place in my heart, as I have been here since kindergarten. The Batch is where I learned to read, write, solve math problems, and many other skills and lessons. It is also where I have met many of my close friends. In addition, I have had so many good memories at the Batch, such as making side shirts with my first grade reading buddy. Another fond memory was participating in chorus and band during the Veterans Day, winter, and spring concerts. Teachers at the Batch will work extra hard to make sure that you understand what they are teaching. They also do their best to make learning fun and interactive. Our principal, Mr. Colleen, is amazing because he takes the time to learn the name of every student in the entire school. That's close to 500 kids. We are so fortunate to have the Batchelder Parent Organization, or BPO, who help fund so many great field trips and educational programs. My favorite program was the mock game show. I will never forget it because I was chosen to be one of the contestants. How cool is that? Congratulations to all of North Reading as we celebrate the 100th anniversary of the Batchelder.
This time, Andrew gave me such a great segue. I'm going to invite Nicole Beam, the president of the Batchelder Parents Organization. There's so many parents here, familiar faces that participate, that our schools are as successful as our parent volunteers. Our BPO is vital to our success with the fundraising, the enrichment opportunities they bring to our students, including author Jacqueline Davies, who was here yesterday, and they also helped with the refreshments for today's festivities. So please give a nice warm welcome to Nicole Gaines.
Thanks, everyone.
22 years. And in that time, I've had the privilege to work with several superintendents. Dr. David Trojan, Dr. Manville, Ms. Willis is in the back. Give away to Kathy Willis. Our current superintendent. As I said before, it's the relationships and the people who challenge each other to be the best that they can. And every superintendent I've worked with in North Reading has challenged me to be better, including the superintendent. Please welcome Superintendent of Schools, John Bernard.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you, Mr. Colleen, our distinguished guests. A lot of our teachers from the Batchelder School are here today, parents, the community as a whole, and to our students, good morning. It's always a pleasure for me to visit schools in my daily work and to meet with students and to meet with teachers, but today is extra special. My coming to the Batchelder School to join all of you in celebrating 100 years of this wonderful school is a tremendous legacy. It's remarkable for a school to have thrived over the course of a century. The Batchelder School and all of our schools in North Reading enjoy tremendous support from parents and the larger community, and the many contributions have been vital to the continued success of the Batchelder School. These contributions and the energy and the enthusiasm of the staff, the students, and the teachers, and of Mr. Colleen has been a strong and successful formula, resulting in high levels of academic achievement, valued traditions, and strong school and community spirit. While we are celebrating today a school that has been an integral part of this community for a century, it remains a lively and a forward-thinking school. The emphasis on the development of the whole child, promotion of digital learning and other 21st century learning skills, and a tight-knit school community that strongly values education are just a few examples of how the Batchelder School has been able to move with the times to ensure that its students are well-equipped to succeed in their life pursuits. For it is here that the students of the Batchelder School are given a solid foundation of both formal and life education, placing them on a path to gaining what they need to be successful in their life pursuits and thus the realization of their dreams. The substantial renovation and the building addition that took place just over a decade ago at the Batchelder School is also an example of the value that our community places on education and the desire that so many have to provide our young people with high-quality school facilities. But education is multidimensional. It's never solely about preparation for future work. While we constantly look forward to our students excelling in their chosen life pursuits, we also value the development of their potential as individuals and the enhancement of the important personal qualities that contribute to their development as good people and good citizens of the world. Each student is unique and deserves his or her opportunities. At the same time, the process of education itself is equally important and something to be enjoyed and valued, and this is true each and every day at the Batchelder School. There is something special in all of our schools in North Reading, a certain positive spirit and an appreciation for the work that is done by those who teach and learn in them. I know that Mr. Batchelder would be very proud to have his name long associated with this school and all of the wonderful people who have passed through its halls and classrooms over the years. As we soon enter the next century in the life of the L.B. Batchelder Elementary School, I am confident that all will continue to make good use of the many resources in this vibrant school, the active participation of parents, the support of the community, and draw from the strong tradition of both academic achievement and the whole person development of students to get even further ahead in the years to come. The years ahead are very bright for the community of the Batchelder School and for all of North Reading, and I am honored to be here today to commemorate this special occasion. Happy birthday to the Batchelder School. Thank you all very much.
This time, I know I saw it, Janine and Brianna are here, I didn't see if anybody else came. Anybody else in the school committee here? Julie's here, where are you, Julie? And Julie. I'm gonna invite the chair of this North Reading School Committee, the work that the school committee does in advocating for our schools is so important. They work so well with the town offices. I actually think the town manager is here, right? Town administrator. No, I don't know what capacity he's here. He's now a parent of a kindergarten student. So I didn't catch you on the way in to find out how you were serving today, but thank you so much for coming. But everybody works together in this town. And as hard as it can be at times, it is so important to know that the officials are always trying to find the best solution for every part of the community of North Reading. So please welcome the chair of the North Reading School Committee, Mr. Mel Webster.
Good morning. I was kind of disappointed Sean took a little stool out here because I probably got used to it. Just curious, how many former Batch Bulldogs are here today? A few. That's good to see. It's good to see. You know, when I walked in this morning, I looked around the school, I said, well, I hope I look this good when I'm 100. But seriously, congratulations to the Batch community on this momentous occasion. Sean has been beaming all morning, and that's no surprise. And don't buy into this 22 years thing he's been telling you. Sean has actually been principal of school for the entire 100 years. And that's despite the fact he doesn't look a day over 40. Sean alluded to this, and many of you are probably aware that this day almost didn't happen. It was about 20 years ago. I wasn't on the school committee yet, but I was in the middle of the battle that Sean talked about. There was a big move afoot to build a new Swan Pond Elementary School to replace the rapidly decaying Batch, and I can't say rapidly enough in that sentence. There was a long, drawn-out, and really ugly battle. There was a group of town that opposed the new school, and they had good reasons. They felt that we had to come up with a plan of what we're going to do with the old school. Police station there, we put a town hall there, we put the library there, what would we do with it? And they were also concerned that the school would be in the middle of nowhere, which it would have been, in the middle of nowhere. But I supported it because the plans to fix this place looked extremely costly. But after several votes, town meeting votes, votes at the polls, some that were extremely close, I think one lost about nine or 10 votes to build a new school. The Swan Pond plan was abandoned and we turned back to how to fix the Batch. I never thought the day would come that I would thank that group that vigorously opposed the Swan Pond project and actually cost the town an additional several million dollars, but today is that day. And I think it was well worth the battle, and I really hate to say this, but they were right. More than 10 years after this project was completed, I'm still amazed at what the building has become. The former Batch students here, and probably some of the parents, probably had the fortune, be it good or bad, to see the old school, and if you didn't, it's a shame, because the transformation has been amazing. Josie earlier mentioned the library, which is a great space. That used to be the gym. And I was involved in a lot of youth sports as my kids grew up, and one of the sports I coached was basketball, despite my diminutive size. And the gym here was a trip. There were no out of bounds. The out of bounds of the gym were the wooden panel walls. And there was stuff all over the place. I don't know what the stuff was. It was some kind of equipment. There was a janitor's closet. There was secret stairs. And it had a light, like one or two big lights. And they turned off. You kind of had to cancel practice. It took about 15 minutes for the light to come back on after you switched it back on. So it was, there were things in this, it's a beautiful building, the original building, but to see the transformation, you're missing a little bit if you didn't have the chance to see what the old Batch looked like. The revitalized Batch is an indication of the incredible support for education in North Reading. The town had to make a huge leap of faith when it approved this project, because we had to approve the entire cost. At that time, the state had said they weren't going to reimburse any towns or schools over a 2 or 3 year period because they were reorganizing how they administered new school building projects in Massachusetts. And the town still went forward. And we were fortunate that the project was completed in such a fashion. The state came out after we built the school, took a look at it, was pleased with what we had done, and decided to retroactively reimburse us for, I think, $7 million, which really helped in terms of getting the school completed. As with the high school and middle school project and earlier renovations with the little school, North Reading residents have always risen to the challenge to provide top quality educational facilities, as well as top quality educational staff and administration, and an unbelievable school committee. And I thank you all. You're supposed to laugh at the unbelievable school committee. In closing, today is a great day. Not only do we celebrate the Batch 100, but 40 years ago on this date, Bruce Springsteen released the classic album, Born to Run. I can't think of a school more born to run into its next 100 years than the Batch. Happy birthday.
Celebrate its 100th anniversary at an event on September 23rd, 2017, in
Central School was opened in 1917 to meet the needs of students in elementary and middle grades and replace three small schools, two of which were one-room schoolhouses. And whereas on March 24th, 1990, the Board of Selectmen of the Town of North Reading voted to name the Central School in honor of Leland Dennis Batchelder, a former member of the school board of the Vision School. Whereas the Elgin Batchelder School has expanded multiple times to meet the needs of the community through the growth of the North Reading area. And whereas the Elgin Batchelder School was renovated in 2006 to both preserve the building's historic significance and better educate today's students. And whereas the Elgin Batchelder School continues to nurture students and challenge them to be the best they can be, therefore be it resolved that the Massachusetts General Court hereby congratulates the Elgin Batchelder School on its 100th anniversary and further extends its sincere best wishes to continue to success in all its future endeavors. It be resolved that the copy of the resolution to be forwarded by the Clerk of the House and the Clerk of the Senate to the Town of North Reading, signed by the Speaker of the House, Robert Leo, the Clerk of the House, Stephen James, the President of the Senate, Stanley Rosenberg, the Clerk of the Senate, William Mulch, my counterpart in the State Senate, Bruce Tarr, and myself, Brad Jones. Congratulations and happy birthday.
At this time, I'd like to welcome up Senator Bruce Tarr.
With enough awards. And so, I want this citation from myself and my colleagues in the Senate to say thank you. And also, this town has two other very good friends who aren't here today, but who very much care about the community, and they are a governor and lieutenant. So Representative Jones and I reached out to them and told them about this incredible celebration. And so we also have a birthday card, and this one's very short, so I'll read it. From the LD Batchelder School, or to the LD Batchelder Elementary School, on behalf of the citizens of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, I extend warm greetings to you on the joyous occasion of your 100th anniversary. This 23rd day of September in the year 2017, by Charles D. Baker, the Governor of the Commonwealth, and Karen E. Polito, the Lieutenant Governor of the Commonwealth. And as I present this to you, I want us to think about the fact that oftentimes at a birthday celebration, we have a huge number of candles, in this case, an incredibly large number of candles, and you blow them out, and you make a wish. But two things are important about that here today. Number one, the wish has already come true. And number two, the lights still burn brightly for a great future. Happy birthday.
On the TV, and there was Chris. She's already setting up that, so we'll thank her later. And then we have students who are well-trained to take you on a brief tour of the building if you're interested. So if you're a current student family, you want a little bit more about what the building was then as compared now, please enjoy a tour start to finish. It's about 15 minutes. But you're also, if you are more of a, like to fly solo, go ahead and enjoy. The building is beautiful. It's prepared for today and for tomorrow. Thank you very much for making the Batchelder School special place.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm
Johnson last
and then
year.
You got Miss Hewitt, right?
Yeah. So this is the gym.
And so this part, I believe, is a new addition.
Yeah.
Yeah. School.
Yeah.
From last time.
Nice.
And back we go. These are some old paintings and photographs of the Batchelder School.
Yes, these are
four headed new additions.
Photograph that we will see again
soon.
Yeah, we'll see that. That painting in the picture in the middle.
We'll see that at one point.
Yes, that's the original.
You want to go?
Here is our principal's office.
Yeah.
This is the principal's office.
So we have the
this
lobby
is the principal's
right
office.
Here, the principal's office.
Kindergarten and first grade hallway.
We have the art room and the music room
Wait.
Down here.
It's going to be here first. So this is our.
This
here's
is
some
the kindergarten
rooms and first graders and kindergartners are down here.
Wow. Yes. These are many.
Many lockers.
Yeah. Artwork and lockers
artwork
for the kindergarten.
Many lockers. As you can
you
see.
Do you have your own lockers? Do you use all of you?
We don't have lockers.
I have feet.
Well, I don't.
I have cubbies.
Look at Tom with shadows.
In the classrooms?
Yeah, I have cubbies in the classrooms.
So So you guys wear backpacks to school and have to put in your cubby and all that stuff? Mm-hmm. Some classrooms hold artwork along the lights in the ceiling.
Oh, yeah.
That's how they display their artwork. You can take a peek inside of any of the classroom.
What's your favorite subject?
No, I'd say
like
writing or reading. Science.
I love both.
I love science. Yeah, science is like
plus we have good. Amazing teachers too.
That's
down here we have many good subjects. The art teacher likes to display any artwork. You can see we have
this is the art room. Yeah, my parents, my grandparents
fantastic.
We have many projects right now. The food figures are working on Kachina dolls.
Oh, so all of the kids come in here. Yes. The different grades come in to do the artwork.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so you do move around.
Yes, you do stuff too.
Two different classrooms during the day.
Yeah. You can see some of the artworks on display
here. This right over here is a mural that the fifth graders made a couple years ago.
About 3 years ago.
And every year the fifth graders make a mural for the school. There's a couple in the cafeteria. There's one right here. There's a couple more.
Why don't you talk about
you
what
oh yeah,
need.
Let's go on
okay,
the
so let's go to the next place, the library.
So this is the library.
This used to be the gym.
This used to be the gym a long time ago before.
And these archways here, these used to be covered up with mats for sound ventilation.
So they could just absorb the sound.
Yeah.
They used to all be covered up. And then if you go up these stairs, you, the computer lab, which is right over here, used to be the basement for the school a while ago.
Mm-hmm.
This is
and
the
that used to be the basement.
That used to be what?
That used to be the basement, the computer lab.
But imagine this, these archways were all covered up with, just covered.
With doormats to absorb all the sound.
What's up?
So you came to the school 6 years ago?
Yes, I started here in 1951. I went to school here for 4 years. And then, you know where your library is? I went to fifth grade there. You know the big building on the hill? You know, the place you guys used to slide down the hill here? Yeah, I used to slide there too. I went to sixth grade there. And then in the seventh grade, there used to be a big building over here that you guys just tore down. When it was brand spanking new, I went there. And I got out in, what's that say in the back? What are the dates?
1958 to 2014.
But what's the first number?
1958.
Okay, so that was actually, I went 1957, I got out in 1963. And then I
1964.
Do you know Don Bennett?
Yes.
My brother. Oh, Vicky! Vicky! Oh. Don't we look good for, how old are we?
70.
She was a year behind me, and I was in love with her. Amazing.
Oh my God.
You remember when my mother used to work here?
Well, we're getting there. I don't know.
You know what that used to be?
Yeah, that was a gym.
Well, that's what Linda. Yeah.
I was looking for the basketball.
Yeah.
I was looking for the basketball. Yes.
Yeah.
This was the computer lab.
And the computer lab was also used as a classroom, even though it was the basement.
It always leaked in the wintertime and
you
got water.
Yeah, get water, so you couldn't put your backpack on the floor. So here's what we're actually making now. It's the maker space. We're gonna have stuff like for the little kids. As you can see, there's like a Lego wall over there. And then you're gonna get like a challenge to try to solve with the limited stuff you have. to solve the actual
challenge.
The
kindergartners.
And so it's called the makerspace, and the computer room is actually great.
This is where we do all our digital learning, typing, and all that learning stuff. This is where I learned to type. And we do all our projects and book reports mainly here, like scratch and stuff.
You can also study for a project with some of the things we have.
Use this to point out what's on the smart board.
Yeah. Well, now if we go to the floor above this one.
This is the
old part of the British one. That's my classroom, actually. That's my personal classroom. If you go over here, see these entryways and the arches that you can see, like right up here? That's very unique because no part of the school has that ever. And if you go over here, this is Keen's class. Half of Keen's class was the secretary's office. It was so small, it only fit three people at one time. Was the computer lab from the early 1980s renovation. So all in here was the computer lab for a while.
Everybody left.
From the early 1980s.
This is
Mr. Rex's
room.
And this is Gavin's room. This is small with half of her class, the cubby area. So like, right in here was the principal's office. That was just the principal's office. It had paneled walls and only enough room for a desk, chair, and a bookcase. And now, if you look at this picture,
this is the same exact picture in 1918.
It's the exact same thing right up there.
Wow.
So you can actually stand in the exact place.
That's
where
cool.
It was.
If we go outside, we have to stand in the same place.
Yeah. Right. So in here. You stand right here, you're standing in the exact same place as they were standing before.
Right here.
Mm-hmm.
Also where we practice.
We're standing right here.
So that's where those people in 1918, the first year of the school was actually opened.
They're trying to
stood. And there's a lot of similarities.
Oh, I don't want to be in
the window on the top is the same.
This used to be
the library. You saw the library now.
This used to be the library. This is like, imagine how small this library would be. Imagine all the bookcases.
This used to be a library?
Yeah. And there's another thing especially unique about this floor.
There's
a little window above the door that you just open to get like cross ventilation between the classroom and outside. Some still open, some don't, but no other part of the school has that.
See, look,
top of their door.
This Miss Keen's room, it has it open right there. That's the cross ventilation. Right there.
This is
cross ventilation. And down here,
it's actually more down on the second floor. And the town of North Reading did not actually have a high school until 1957. So if you were in high school, you would have to go to Reading High School because it didn't have another high school in North Reading until
1957.
I
see your room?
Yeah,
that's our room.
But there's nothing really special in
there. The big room, so these are all the names.
All right.
So,
all right, we're going next.
All the names in the class.
This is my classroom.
This is awesome because it has no other classrooms. Only on the fourth floor, since it's on the top of the hill, you can go out and it has these
Yeah, no other classroom has a door in their classroom or near it.
Yeah, only like the classroom across.
This is a table for working.
Right. And there's still more downstairs. Mrs. Conner's class was actually built in, it's not original. This wasn't here the first 100 years. It was actually built in, I don't know when, but not too long ago. I know that.
So if we go downstairs,
this room here.
This room
here. There's no part of the building. So
this, that's where it always used to flood. That was a classroom.
And,
that was a classroom. It always used to flood in there.
They went that way.
Oh.
And down here, down the hall, when this is. Okay, down here, that is storage, and this is your bathroom and stuff. In Miss Sylvia's room, right here, this used to be a shower room. Because this school used to go up
to nine grades.
One to nine. But this used to be a shower room. There used to be tiles all along the floor, all along the walls.
That used to be the art room.
This used to be the art room.
You can't go in it because it's locked up.
Yeah. Please close your door. You can't go in because it's locked right now, yeah. But that used to be a tiny art room. These walls are all original from the old building. Everything.
Everything here is original.
And you have stuff to play with.
That, like, kind of concludes it for.
Yeah.
There's not much else to say.